So, is Masterclass worth it? I've been spending the last 30 days checking out the experience, and I have a few opinions that I wanted to share, and also dive into some of the features that I liked, some of the things that I didn't particularly like, and give you my conclusion about my experience. So let's start with a bit of an overview, then dive into the features, and then round up with a summary. So to start with, I downloaded Masterclass about 30 days ago. So I've been using masterclass.com on the Mac, but also the application as well on iOS. And as you can imagine, I downloaded it to check out whether it's something that's suitable for those people who are looking to learn something brand new. And in my opinion, I'd seen all of the ads, as you can imagine, and I was impressed by a few of the courses. The first one was the Howard Schultz one, the Bob Iger one, and also some of the negotiation ones as well. And I was also interested in a few of the other business and leadership ones too. As you can imagine, I do like taking courses. I have recently been jumping into a few online courses. I'm actually taking the Focus course by Sean Blanc at the moment, and I'm pretty impressed with that one. But in the case of Masterclass, I'd seen all the ads, and as you can imagine, the price was quite high. So I decided to check it out before sharing it. And it did have a 30-day guarantee, so I could technically return it today if I wanted to. Now, with the All Access Pass, you get access to over 75 of the instructors. And the first thing I'd say is the quality is fantastic. Watching the videos is very aesthetically pleasing. And that's why I've titled this video The Netflix for Courses, because it's almost like they've really well produced these features. And what's cool as well is you don't actually have to just listen to the video. You can listen to the audio as well on the iOS device, which allows you to switch between them, which is perfect for when you're on the go. And I actually thought of this the other day, like, I don't want to have to sort of minimize it. Just want to sort of play it like a podcast if I'm walking. Now, what I've been doing in the mornings is waking up a little bit, maybe 10 minutes earlier. And after I have my cup of tea and do my journal, I head upstairs. And what I've been doing is jumping on Masterclass for about 10 minutes, which means I do about a lesson. And I've completed one full course in that period of time, 30 days. And I've taken about 17 or so other lessons, and they've been dotted about the other services. So the full course that I did was the Bob Iger business leadership one and strategy. And I was pretty impressed with that. I didn't think I'd enjoy it as much as I did. But what I quite like is that he talks quite holistically about things. So the pros of that was obviously that you get to hear sort of what's going on behind the scenes with the business and also how he decides to plan his strategy. But also I can see, for example, people who maybe have done business degrees, then it may have been a little bit tricky because it seems to be quite basic in terms of he's talking very holistically about stuff. Now, in terms of takeaways, I've actually been trying to replan some of my business strategy in the last few days, taking into account some of his notes. And I was throughout those sessions taking notes on the remarkable advice, which I'm currently reviewing, which I was pretty impressed with in being able to sort of just take quick notes across the sessions that I was doing. So in terms of other features, I also started taking the economics one, and I'm about four classes into that. And also the Sarah Blakely one, which is actually really impressive at the moment, and I'm currently on the prototyping module. The one thing I'd say is the more specific the teacher or the instructor, the better the class seems to be. I found that the economics one is really advanced, more than, maybe it's because I don't know too much about economics, but at the same time, it really does teach you all that you need to know about economics as a collective. Whereas, say, the Bob Iger one was much more general. The one that I'm also finding pretty impressive is the Jeff Goodby and Rich Silverstein one, which is all about how to make effective adverts and really try and engage your audience. And to be honest, I'm actually impressed with that one as well. So one thing I've found is that I've been pretty impressed with the way they deliver classes and the way they put stuff together. So if I had to be very critical about the experience as a whole, I would say the classes could be perceived as very general. However, at the same time, you do get access to some skills that you could potentially learn from a general perspective. For example, I'm actually looking at some of the cooking ones. There's a Mexican cooking class on there, and it being very general would actually really help me because I can sort of make a good leap forward with it whilst not being too confused. And I guess if you're looking for a more skill-based sort of experience, you may be looking in the wrong place with Masterclass. This is very much a introductory to some extent, advanced way to learn. So, for example, let's say you're someone that's looking to start writing. If you take the James Patterson course, it's going to take you through all of the basics, but also all of the intermediates, ready for you to push out into the advanced. It's really to get you started. They do have workbooks and lesson comments as well at the end of every lesson, which is pretty cool. I never used any of them, but taking the notes actually helped me to retain a lot of the information. So all in all, I think Masterclass is great, and as I said, it's more particular for those who are looking to learn a skill from scratch and maybe get it taught in a very professional manner. I think the classes are actually of really good quality. There's no umming and ahhing, which you would find maybe in a Skillshare class, like you would if you found my one. But at the same time, you're not going to be learning a very tangible skill. You're going to be learning sort of a very general skill versus a very tangible skill, if that makes sense. If you're looking for tangible skills, I recommend Skillshare. You can check out that I've got a 2 month free code below, so you can check out that and you can get 2 months free premium. And you can check out the Masterclass link below. There might be some discounts if I manage to find some. But I was impressed overall. And so far, I'm going to be carrying on this sort of daily morning habit of doing like 10 minutes of Masterclass every morning. And I guess it's something that if you were in that sort of stage where you're looking to learn a few new things, so say for example, I'm looking to learn a bit of economics at the moment and also business strategy and leadership, and the Howard Schultz one will find very valuable, but also the advertising stuff. I think you'll end up learning a few things like that. So guys, that was my review of Masterclass. A few sort of pros, a few sort of cons, but I think overall it's a pretty good platform. So guys, thank you so much. Make sure to like the video if you enjoyed it. If you're new here on the channel, please do subscribe, and I'll talk to you all very, very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.